Welcome back to Upfront. The field for the 2012 U.S. Senate race in Wisconsin is becoming clear. Former Republican Governor Tommy Thompson launched a campaign ad and filed election papers last week. Thompson joins a Republican field that already includes former Congressman Mark Newman. An announcement from Assembly Speaker Jeff Fitzgerald is expected this week. On the Democratic side, Madison Congresswoman Tammy Baldwin has a field all to herself, and it appears it may stay that way. Congresswoman Baldwin joins us now on Upfront. It's good to have you back on the program.
It's great to be back.
Why don't you have any competition? Why doesn't anybody want to run against you? What's your opinion on that?
Look, I can't explain that, but what I can tell you is why I'm running. And, you know, people in the middle class in Wisconsin right now are taking it on the chin. And I hear stories every day. And what I also hear is the frustration about the debates and the policies that are being discussed in Washington, D.C. and in Madison. And there's this disconnect, and people are furious. I share that frustration. And really, that is why I'm running for the Senate. Working class and middle class families need a champion, a fighter right now. You know, the stories I hear are really familiar these days. Moms and dads who fear that they won't be able to save for their kids' college education like their parents did for them. Couples facing dipping into their retirement savings just to pay their mortgage and to make their bills and wondering whether they'll ever be able to retire. I talked to a dad who's working two jobs today and making less than when he only had one job, and it deprives him of a chance to be with his kids. And those are the lucky ones because they're still employed. The long-term unemployed are being discriminated against now when they're applying for jobs. People aren't accepting applications from folks who have been out of work for more than 6 months. It's really staggering right now, but what is so frustrating is the disconnect between these debates in Washington and Madison and real people's lives, and I want to fight for the middle class.
I asked Congressman Ryan about it in the first segment. What's your take on this Occupy Wall Street thing? Is that what you're talking about? Is that part of the frustration that you say, the disconnect that you feel out there?
Well, I think it's one manifestation of it. People are wondering who is listening. They want their leaders to care and to get it and to hear from them. And when they see these debates in Madison and Washington that seem so disconnected to their everyday struggles and their realities, they come out on the streets. We saw that here in Wisconsin. We're seeing that now at the national level. And I think Wall Street, of course, is particularly symbolic because we look at some of the misdeeds and beyond misdeeds, some of the gambling that was done with Americans' life savings that led to this financial ruin, and they see no one's being held accountable. It's like there's two sets of rules, rules for Wall Street and rules for ordinary Americans, and people who work hard and play by the rules aren't getting ahead. They're falling behind, and yet they haven't seen anybody held to account on Wall Street.
Do you think that sounds like the class warfare argument Republicans would say? It sounds like you're talking about it's us against them. That's the kind of the conversation we're having. Is that the conversation we're having?
What I think is that if leaders, especially elected leaders, listen to the people who sent them to Washington and to Madison to do a job, they would be doing a different job. I mean, if you're listening, you'd be fighting for jobs and fighting to strengthen our economy. And instead, they see these other debates and wonder whose business are they doing. You know, the bidding that is done for the powerful special interests, both in Washington and in Madison, it sometimes leaves me aghast. We are fighting. We need to have leaders who are committed to fighting for the people. And right now, I think that the survival of the middle class is really in question.
When people, do you think it's in question?
I see it shrinking. Look at the recent statistics from the Census Bureau for Wisconsin, that over the past decade, middle class incomes went down over 14%, far ahead of the national average, I might add. That's a huge step backward over a decade of time. That's unacceptable. We have, you know, the American dream, the belief that if you work hard and play by the rules, you get ahead and your next generation does better. People are in doubt about that right now. We need to rescue the American dream and we need to fight for the middle class.
Briefly, do you think the American Jobs Act is a good piece of legislation? Why aren't some Democrats even supporting that piece of legislation? Or is it just campaign fodder? It's something great to run on, but never really was going to be anything that was seriously considered.
You know, I do think it's a good piece of legislation, and I was pleased to hear President Obama talk about many of the ideas that I've been talking about in my campaign. Putting people back to work right away, dealing with our crumbling infrastructure, roads, bridges, and schools, emphasizing the key components to economic growth, education, innovation, and infrastructure. And so I was really pleased to see the American Jobs Act. And what I say beyond that is that he brought forth a combination of issues that have received bipartisan support year in and year out. So the fact that the House Republicans are not bringing this immediately to the floor is pure politics. It's pure presidential campaign politics. And the fact that they put those politics over the interests of the people they represent makes me angry.
I want to have you address something that you've addressed a million times already, and this is whether you're too liberal to be elected U.S. Senator in the state of Wisconsin. I don't want to frame the question that way. Let me say this. How do you appeal to independents who will look at your voting record and will say she supported the bank bailout, she supported the stimulus package, she wanted universal health care? Why are you a better choice for independent voters than, say, someone like a Tommy Thompson?
Well, first of all, I'm listening. And what I do in Washington is fight for the people that I represent. And I want that to be the whole state of Wisconsin. You know, the middle class right now is taking it on the chin. They're struggling. And right now, too many of my colleagues just don't get it and are instead pursuing things that are disconnected to the reality of people they represent. Now, I believe that we must be serious about our debt and our deficits. But we have to do so in a way that that preserves the investments that are investments in our economic growth. So the president said at the State of the Union, to win the future, we must out-educate, out-innovate, and out-build the rest of the world. Those are the key things that I think we protect at the same time that we absolutely need to cut elsewhere. One of the things I've proposed, of course, is to bring our troops home from Afghanistan on a much more rapid timetable than this president would necessarily do. But I think the things that I've stood for over my tenure are things that are very much in line with the vast majority of Wisconsinites. And I go beyond Democrats and independents. I'd say many Republicans, too.
Wisconsin Congresswoman Tammy Baldwin, now candidate for U.S. Senate. We appreciate your time today. Thanks
My
very
pleasure.
Much for being with us.
Thank you.
A secret investigation focusing on individuals with connections to Governor Walker. The politics and risks for the governor when Upfront continues. And a reminder, Upfront is now on Facebook.